Let's take a look at how you can add an iOS app to Bitrise. After logging in, click on the Add New App button and then choose the web UI. Choose the Bitrise account you want the app to be added to. It can be either your personal account or an organization. Choose a privacy type for your app. It can be either private or public. If it's public, anyone can see your logs and configs, so be sure to use this with care. We'll set this one to private. Select your repository from the source code provider of your choice. You can choose GitHub, Bitbucket, GitLab, or add something else manually. The test app we're going to use is stored on GitHub. When prompted to set up repository access, you can either add your own SSH key, which comes in handy if you need to set up multiple sub-repositories, or just go for the No Auto Add SSH Key option. Choose and type the name of your branch. Pick one that includes the config of your project. My branch is called Master. And now the validation of the repository is running. Bitrise will check if it's fully accessible and also look for your configuration files, setting your app up based on what it finds. When it comes to iOS apps, Bitrise is going to look for Xcode project or Xcode workspace paths by default. The validation will fail if you do not have a shared scheme in your project. No worries though, you can still point Bitrise in the right direction by manually adding the path to your Xcode scheme. Let's fast forward a bit. Bitrise detected an iOS app. Great, we're in business. Next, we need to select the IPA export method. You can modify this later on. For now, let's choose development. Once you've clicked it, you should see your project or workspace path, schema name, IPA export method, and your Xcode stack. You can edit these if you need to, or click confirm. Now, you can add an icon to your app. If you have one in your repo, choose that, or upload one, or skip for now. At this point, you also need to decide if you want Bitrise to add webhooks to your repository or not. If you do register webhooks, your project's source control events from GitHub can trigger builds for you. For example, when you push some new code to one of your branches. Let's try registering one. Your first build is running. Click on a big green button and you'll be taken to the build's landing page. In the next video, you can learn how to configure steps and workflows. You want to be an expert? Check out the whole playlist for the topic, link in the description below. Visit our website, bitrise.io. Subscribe!